back in the saddle to film another build review. Model rectifier sent over. Italeri's kit number 3629, 1/24th scale Range Rover Classic 50th anniversary. That is a long name. It's a limited edition kit. You can build it as a US edition or a European edition. I always like the European edition. This is what I see most over there. I don't see a lot of these in the United States. So I'm going to build it up as a European edition. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box when you get yours. We'll start off with the clear parts tree, and that you can barely, if you take your hand away and line it up just right, you can see how perfectly clear. It's like they used real glass. That is pretty impressive. All kinds of greenhouse space on that model because it's got some large windows in that cab. We've got a huge set of decals, lots of license plates, registration. We got the Range Rover name for the hood and the deck, so we don't have to worry about that. We got some gauges. We got instruments. We got the heater sliders and everything like that. That's what that looks like. Smaller Range Rover emblems, 50th anniversary emblems. So it is a sharp looking decal sheet. And we've got a set of four off-road, definitely off-road, all-terrain tires. No name brand on the sidewall. That's absolutely fine. Nice looking, and they are a solid rubber to slide over the wheels. Let's look at all the plastic that's in the kit. Most of it is molded in black. We've got a nice interior set, so you really wouldn't even need to throw any paint on this kit if you wanted to do a black interior. I'm not doing that. I'm going to be painting it, but it'll make priming and painting a lot easier with the black background. Got the inside of our tailgate, it looks like. Steering wheel. We got a full set of disc brakes. Check them out on that side. Check them out on that side. We got our wheels here, so if you wanted to do any other wheel color but black, you'll have to paint it. Looks like a spare carrier with a fabric cover. Nice looking tree there. On this one here, we have our dash options. You can see we got the factory dashboard, and then you'll decide which instrument cluster and glove box you will install. Nice flush fitting. That should look lovely. These look like seat backs here. We got some fuel tanks, full exhaust system, two different types of wipers depending on the model that you build. We've got what looks like behind the grill work here, steering components, differentials, drive shafts, parking brake, four-wheel drive, shift levers. Nice parts on there. Even looks like a set of possible optional fog lights. On this tree, we've got the main chassis pan for our interior. Engine molded in. You can easily paint that up or just dry brush it. I'll have to Google quick what color Range Rover engines are, if it's even worth painting, or if they're just a black color like a lot of Toyotas are. We've got our door panels inside. Mine will need to be painted. I'm not going with a black interior. We've got the mirrors, frame pieces. You can see trailing arms and suspension. Bumpers molded in black, that's nice. Three pedal arrangement. So we've got all kinds of good detail on there, and we've got that Range Rover Classic body. So it is a curbside, the hood does not open, but if you crave something opening on the vehicle, you can cut the tailgate. These are nice seams here, so it'll look realistic if you leave it closed, but they are thin. So if you want, you can cut from the back side and have an opening lift and tailgate. So that will be nice when you want to work on that. But we've got some beautiful body molding lines. We got positive locations to mount things like mirrors. We got that little mini hood scoop we can detail later. All well done, molded nicely. So that's everything in the box. I'm going to get to pushing mine together, and I'll be right back. Total time invested in the kit before I can start putting it in paint is just over an hour. There's no engine or anything to assemble, so it starts to go together real easy. Now, if you want it to go a nice way out, that body already has a nice shine to it. A coat of Future floor polish on there, if you wanted to do the white version, would look really tough. The box top shows the insert for the fuel tank as being body color. So I glued that in, and I will end up painting that with the body. if it's not that way in the real world. There actually is no color call out in the manual for that little insert. It doesn't say that it remains black or anything. And the box top shows it as being white. And I looked up pictures on the internet and they're hard to find. So of this side of the vehicle. So whatever, we're gonna paint that body color and that's just the way life's gonna be. So we've got that all set to go. I cut off that little brace in there so we can get paint around everything. And the body is straight and true. We've got our grille mirrors and rear view mirror. So we'll get those painted up. The bumpers, they say, should be a metallic aluminum color, so we'll get those painted on their own tree. I like to cut things separate. I want to do all the interior panels, the inside of the tailgate, the door panels, the side panels, in a lighter color than the rest of the vehicle. I don't want to do it in a black color. The dashboard glued together for the European drive, for the right-hand drive, so you put the glove box on the left, and the steering wheel column and instrument cluster on the right. If you want to do the American version, you do it the opposite. And we've got the brake, shift, and four-wheel drive lever all set on that center console. I'll be painting that up and then lightly hand detailing the small boots and stuff on those. The reason I like to do that is I go for strength, and I can hand paint steady enough still, even in my old age, that I can get those detailed. The steering wheel will be the same color as the dashboard, so that's cut off and ready to go with it. Spare tire cover will match the interior. So I've got that all glued together and be painting it up with the interior pieces. These parts here, the drive shaft, the final sway linkages, the fuel tank, this suspension member on the differential, and the exhaust will all be done up in metallic tones. So I cut everything else free and left them on their trees to paint those up. The wheels are the same way. They'll be in aluminum color. So I'll be priming those. Even though it's in black, I'm going to prime it so that the color coats. I use that Rust-Oleum paint. I don't want it to affect the plastic, and I also want it to grip well on the plastic, so I always use a primer first. It's just the way I go about it. Mud flaps and rear handle will be painted black and then attached to the vehicle. Painted black just to get that plastic shininess off of them. The seats are together. I want to do them in a different fabric tone than black. So I've got them all glued together. We'll get those primered so the paint sticks to it, and then we'll light coat the lighter interior color so that a lot of that shadow and depth shows up and they look like real fabric. Last parts here, we've got the frame assembled. The chassis is one individual piece. I don't have anything painted on it. I left the ends of the tree on it so I can grab a hold of it and paint it, and then I will detail the exhaust, and I've still got to go online to see if I can find out what color the bottom of the engines are. You can scream all you want at the screen, but I can't hear you until this video is all over and it's public. So we've got our suspension and drive line in, got our steering linkages all together. So those are all set up, ready to go. All these little linkages, everything glues in fine. We've got those large posts to put the frame together. It all seems to be lining up. If it doesn't line up appropriately on the chassis, for some reason, I mean, it should build flat because these are fixed pieces. You're not attaching these to anything. They're a part of the frame rail. But I noticed there's a bit of a tweak in the chassis. It's hard to show you in black, but this side's higher than this side. So I might end up having to shave a little bit off this spring mount here to get it to sit level. But we'll see when I get it all glued together. If I push it all together towards the end and it still looks like that, it might just look like that because of the way I'm holding it. I will wait. If I do have to shave anything, I'll let you know that it didn't line up from the box, and then you can know. But it sits perfectly level. We've got these four attachment points and it sits level. There's nothing off angle, and these parts sit down. So maybe just the very back of this is tweaked a little bit. If that's the case, I'm not going to worry about that at all. I'll put the frame on straight, and that should fix it all. So I'm going to get everything into paint. You can see me over there.
Thank you.
As you can see, we're getting things together. We're getting things done. We're ready to go. We just have to do the final assembly after this point and attach the little stuff like the windshield wipers, the gas cap, the mud flaps, the rear door handle. We got our grill to go in. You can see the headlights are just friction fit into the grill with that Molotow chrome background so that they look reflective. And we've got our side mirrors, which will be glued on. The turn signals in the front, the taillights and turns in the back, I highlighted with those markers. You can see those. What I'll have to do on the body is just use a silver marker really quick for a little bit of a highlight underneath where the lights are, and then I'll just glue those on in place with some Mod Podge so that it dries up. I use the Mod Podge for the glass all the time. You've seen me do it. I just apply it with a brush. I always use the gloss, of course, because it's glass. So speaking of Mod Podge, I use that to attach the glass around the vehicle. That is the only thing I'm complaining about so far. I haven't done any test fitting of the body on the chassis or anything, but the glass is just the same size as the frame, which on a model makes it very difficult to apply. It's just hangs over like a micron. Not, if it was a millimeter, it'd be a lot. Just so putting the windshield in, what I had to do was I had to put in the two pieces of side glass, let the Mod Podge dry, put in the other two pieces of side glass, let it dry, put the back glass in, let it dry, then the windshield. Normally I can put them all in, run beads of Mod Podge around the edges and I'm fine, but these are so small in their relief around the edges that they will fall out, pop out, whatever, if you try to do it too fast. So go easy on that stuff and you'll get it in. You can see I use that black Sharpie to highlight everything and it looks really nice on that sage green paint job, and I really do like that paint job. I used craft paint to do the little hood vent up there, and then I can just clean that off when I need to. We got the wheel and tire package. I did notice they are Michelin logos, and I showed that in the detail. So when I said there was no logo, I just wasn't looking carefully enough. It's got Michelin logo and tire size logos on the side. So when you assemble them, just make sure you put that out if you want those to show on there. And they are a really nice set of wheel and tire package. We got the interior done and the undercarriage. Take a look. I'm just going to take a little of the tan paint and touch up where I cut those off the sprues, and you'll get that sometimes if they make the cutoff points in a very visible area. But we've got our dashboard done, we've got our interior done with the two-tone, got the spare tire mount up there, we are all set to go. That looks nice, and that matches the pictures of the one I saw online. And then underneath we've got our chassis and our bumper and our drive shafts installed. Painted that transmission and transfer case, lined it up with the exhaust, got the drive shafts in, got that little shock absorber on the rear differential installed, and the fuel tank, and glued the bumpers on. And we didn't have any alignment issues. I didn't notice anything that was cattywampus so far, so it must have just been how I was looking at it when I was showing it in the sub-assembly show-off. So I'm going to get the body pressed down. The wheel and tire package presses on pretty easy. I was test fitting those earlier. They're a little hard to line up, but once you get it on there, it just pushes on and stays there where it should. So I will get the body on, then I will get the wheel and tire package pushed on, do my lights, and when I come back, we'll have the final. Here we go with the final of Italeri's Range Rover Classic 50th Anniversary Edition with the limited edition boxing of it, 1970 to 2020, 1/24th scale. Pretty cool model kit. Now, I took it my own way, did it in that beautiful sage green like the one I found online. It builds up quite easily. You're not going to have to struggle with a lot of things or fight with it. When you put the chassis underneath the body, my recommendation is a little different what the owner's manual says. The manual says put the bumpers on the frame first, so that's what I did, and that created all kinds of issues getting the body on. I should have listened to instinct from other builds and did the bumpers later, and that's what I recommend you do. But of course, you can build your own way and build for you. But I recommend leaving those bumpers off, putting the body on the chassis, which might require you to push it up and snap it into that front clip a little bit. But once it's in there, it will stay on its own. Then attach the rear bumpers and you shouldn't have any issues. I, in fact, did accidentally tweak and crack the rear one, and almost did the same to the front bumper trying to get the body on. So that's why I recommend it. The only thing about the kit that I talked about earlier was that the windows can be a little difficult to put in. But other than that, super easy to build. Nice amount of detail for being a curbside. We got all that nice detail underneath. We got all the rest of the kit ready to go. So I highly recommend it. Want to build a Range Rover, a more modern one? They make this in a police version. They make it in an ambulance version. And the regular version here, you could weather it up. You could do whatever you want. The only complaint was how those windows went in. They do go in. You just have to be super, super careful when you do it. As always, thanks to MRC for sending this over. I really appreciate it. I will link in the description where you can grab this kit as it is being released now and should be available at any time from MRC as soon as I get it in stock. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. I appreciate your patronage and watching the show, and we will see you all at the next review.